Hello, welcome to The Daily Show. I'm the host, Joan Stewart.
Yeah! I love you, Joan! Yeah!
Okay. Recently, we've had interest group dilemmas over Bill Clinton's health care plan, and the Democrats and Republicans have been battling over the health plan as well as the Patriot Act. Today, we're going to be having President Bill Clinton as well as AARP's chief lobbyist, John Rother, joining us today to talk about the battles over the health plan. Thank you. Give a warm welcome to Bill Clinton.
Oh, you mean President Bill Clinton,
I'm sorry,
Joan.
President Bill Clinton.
They haven't impeached me yet.
Okay, so a few questions for Bill to begin with. I heard about your health plan. What are you going to do to get your ideas out to the public?
Well, we're really going to use some outsider strategy. We're really focusing on grassroots lobbying, which we center on government officials. We're also throwing in an oil industry tax. It's geared towards groups of people that are directly affected by government policy, such as therapists, chiropractors, pharmaceutical companies, you know, those that the healthcare plan will really affect. Pharmaceutical companies are writing to their shareholders, warning them that profits could suffer if price controls and impede drug research. Other groups have joined in the fight as well. Stationery store owners, formal business owners. Why? Because they may have to pay for health care coverage. They don't want to do that. That'll cost money. They don't want to pay their lower wage workers money if they don't have to.
Today we're trying to get an average American citizen's opinion. Look, there's one. Sir, what do you think of Bill Clinton's new health care plan?
Alright, I own a pharmacy, I pay my workers $2.75 an hour. Shouldn't that be enough? Do I still have to give them health care? I gotta go.
What are some other ways that interest groups strive to advance their causes?
Well, funny you ask that. Groups like the American Medical Association and the National Association of Life Underwriters have increased their campaign contributions to lawmakers of both parties. Money may not be such an effective way to advance causes, I beg to differ, but what these groups are trying to do is get access and increase their influence.
Well, there are several groups that are not taking a position on your health plan. AARP is one of them, and we happen to have Chief Lobbyist John Rother here to join us today.
And here's John Rother, AARP's Chief Lobbyist. Is the AARP taking a stand on this issue?
Well, we have begun an advertising campaign that includes coverage of prescription drugs and long-term health care and the health insurance. But we haven't taken a firm position on influencing the government.
What is the AARP waiting for before it takes its position?
We are waiting to have our town hall meeting to hear the opinions of the members in our group.
Thank you, Rother, for joining us today.
Thank you, Joan.
Word!
AARP's got my back. So the AARP, I don't have to get my meds from Canada anymore. Yeah, Joan, we love you, Joan, go kill you!
Welcome back from the commercial break to our second segment today. In recent news, Congress headed Thursday toward end-of-session showdowns over oil drilling in Alaska. We have Senator Ted Stevens with us today, who is behind all this.
He has been trying to achieve his long-standing goal of opening the Arctic National Wildlife Refuge to oil exploration by adding the plan to a spending bill for the Pentagon.
Yeah, John.
I love you guys.
You're so good.
Thank you for being on my show today. So, Senator Stevens, you have been working on your goal to open the Arctic National Wildlife Refuge to oil exploration. How is that coming?
It is conflicting with many different bills, such as the renewal of the USA Patriot Act, the Hurricane Relief Package, and others dealing with health and education. Also, the Democrats are planning a filibuster to stop the bill. However, Majority Leader Bill Frist said he is confident in getting the 69 votes needed for the cloture motion to overturn the filibuster.
Could you describe the bill?
Yes. This is a public bill because it generally pertains to public affairs. It is a measure to add an oil exploration spending bill to the Pentagon.
There are many critics of this bill, such as Senator Harry Reid of Nevada. He called the bill an egregious abuse of power on behalf of the oil and gas industry to violate the Senate's rules and attack a special interest provision. Do you have a response to this?
Democrats say the Arctic provision is outside the scope of the Pentagon bill, but they reconsidered a filibuster because it would block a critical measure that pays for national defense.
Now we have a live clip of the filibuster.
Albert, 843-6728, 3229 Winfield Avenue. Allen, 297-4632. Mother, Jan. Father, Bill, 2689 Park Place. Baker, 2437292. 8696 Smoky Way. Charles, 7624871. Davis, 8172632. Make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. You take 2 pieces of bread, preferably whole wheat. Then you take 2 tablespoons of peanut butter, spread it on the bread. Then take 1 tablespoon of jelly.
Well, 6 tablespoons, just vote for this so we can stop this.
Jump, jump, run here.
That was so boring. Okay, well, we're back to the show. We have Hillary Clinton with us, joining us today, and we'll be talking about the Patriot Act. Recently, there has been debate on whether to renew the USA Patriot Act, which was passed in the aftermath of September 11th. What are your views on this?
Well, I realize that national security is a very important matter, but I would prefer the Senate version of the bill over the House's version, because it didn't allocate a measure that would ensure domestic security money to states based on the chance of terrorist attacks. Such a measure would really benefit the citizens of New York. I also feel
And that's it. We ran out of time. But we'll see you guys next time.
Yeah, Joe. Woo! Yeah.